Well, it's not often that we get to see and hear from those whose lives have been impacted in a good way by a particular legislation, but the Maryland Citizens Health Commission aims to bring those stories to the forefront. Joining us to talk more about Faces of Maryland's Newly Insured is the president of the Maryland Citizens Health Commission, Vinny DeMarco. Vinny, hi.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. Sure. Yeah, appreciate it. Over 200,000 parents, children, and seniors are now insured as a result of the reform.
That's right. Under the leadership of Governor Martin O'Malley and Lieutenant Governor Brown, Speaker Mike Bush and a General Assembly, we've expanded health care significantly in Maryland. We've gone from 44th in the country to 16th in health care for lower income adults, and we're proud to announce this new book, Faces of Maryland's Newly Insured, that highlights the stories, and these stories are really moving. They show that health reform works, that people's lives are saved, and we all benefit because when they have health care and don't go to the hospital without insurance and get huge bills that they can't pay, we don't have to pay those bills. So it really is good for everyone. And
highlight one of the stories for us, because I know there are so many moving stories in here.
There are so many moving stories, and the best story is a story of a woman in Western Maryland who came to a press conference attended by Republican legislators. Now, I note that our legislation that expanded health care was bipartisan. Mm-hmm. Democrats and Republicans voted for it, passed unanimously out of Delegate Pete Hammond's committee, and that bill helped everyone and all these people. And Crystal Moon came to that press conference and told us how she worked for many years. She didn't have health insurance. She went to school. Her husband worked. She had kids. Her husband couldn't afford health care. They couldn't afford it like many Marylanders. She knew about health insurance for children. She went to local social services, and they said, Ms. Moon, under the new law signed by Governor O'Malley, you can have health care also. She had known about it. She got her card. A couple weeks later, she was feeling ill, and she would have slept it off if she didn't have her insurance card. She went in, the doctor said, Ms. Moon, thank goodness you came. This would have killed you.
Wow.
This would have killed you.
Amazing.
Now, because you have your Medicaid card, we can prevent this from happening. We can save your life. She came to our press conference, said to Republican Delegate Wendell Beitzel and all of us, thank you for saving my life. And that's the message.
Right.
Hundreds of thousands of Marylanders have benefited under these laws, and we believe that this is good news for federal health care reform, because federal health care reform builds on what Maryland and other states have done to achieve health care for almost all Americans, and we all benefit.
Yeah.
According to Families USA, every time we pay an insurance premium, about $1,000 of it goes to health care for the uninsured. That's a hidden health care tax, which these reforms help reduce.
So your message and the many testaments that we see in this book, that health care reform works, but there's still work to be done, right?
There's still work to be done. We're going to build on the federal reform, make sure it's properly implemented, but we want to do more in Maryland. That's why we're proposing a dime a drink increase in the alcohol tax. The reforms passed so far were funded a lot by a dollar increase in a cigarette tax, which has made Maryland the sixth lowest smoking rate in the country and saved lots of lives. The dime a drink alcohol tax can do the same thing, reduce underage drinking, reduce alcohol abuse, save lives, and provide money to expand health care to others. That's why we're so happy to announce, just tomorrow we'll announce, that over 140 candidates for the General Assembly have endorsed this.
Okay.
And we think it's going to happen. Dr. Martin Luther King said that of all the forms of inequality, injustice in health care is the most shocking and inhumane. If he was alive today, he would say, good work, Maryland. You've done a lot. Now finish the job. We're going to do it.
Well, and a timely message. Thank you,
yes.
Vinny DeMarco. Appreciate it.